آدرے می دخت ان صدر نشین گفتگوش مثل گل افشان بھی. جب وہ بولتی ہیں تو لگتا ہے کہ جیسے پھول اڑ رہے ہیں اور فضا میں ایک مہک ہے جو ان کے الفاظ کے ذریعے سے بکھر رہی ہے. میں ان سے گزارش کر رہا ہوں کہ وہ ایسین کی طرف سے استقبال ایسین کی طرف سے صدارتی خطبہ پیش فرمائیں.
بہت بہت شکریہ. صدارتی خطبہ وائس چانسلر صاحب پیش کریں گے. میں اپنی انجمن کی طرف سے ایک حیدرآباد دکن کے بارے میں چند جملے کہنا چاہتی ہوں. اور بہرحال انجمن کی صدر ہوں تو اس لحاظ سے آپ اس تقریر کو کچھ بھی سمجھ لیجئے. ایک خیلی معذرت میں خام از دوستان ایرانی و حمید اور از دانشگاہ مولانا آزاد کے بے زبان اردو موسم از ابتدا یعنی از وقت کے ان انجمن تاسیس شد. دس ہیز بین دا ٹریڈیشن that the presidential address of IPTA is in English. متاسفانے خیلی معذرت میں خام البتہ بے زبان انگلیسی کا عدود حداد کے کاملاً ماشاء اللہ مسلط تسلط داران بے زبان انگلیسی مثل زبان فرانسوی و زبان ہے یہ مختلف جہان. ود دا پرمیشن آف دا چیئر بنام فیض بخش دانش آموز کے دلہا گشت ازوے فیض اندوز تراوت بخش حرف تر زبانان لطافت سنجے طبع نقطے دانان. وائس چانسلر مولانا آزاد نیشنل اردو یونیورسٹی پریسیڈنٹ آف دا سیشن جناب اغے پروفیسور غلام علی حداد عدیل ڈاکٹر پدم بھوشن ڈاکٹر موسیٰ رضا وائس چانسلر ڈاکٹر عبدالحق اردو یونیورسٹی پروفیسر مظفر شاہمیری صاحب خانم میڈم لکشمی دیوی راج آغائے دکتر احسان اللہ شکر اللہی و خانم دکتر مہرو زادے لیڈیز اینڈ جنٹلمن اینڈ مینی فرینڈس اینڈ ڈسٹنگوشڈ پیپل پروفیسر رفیق فاطمہ ڈاکٹر یوسف ٹریجر آف دا آئپٹا اینڈ مینی مینی ادرز لیڈیز اینڈ جنٹلمن آئی وش ٹو ویلکم یو آل to the 36th session International Conference of All India Persian Teachers Association hosted by the Maulana Azad National Urdu University at the historic city of Hyderabad. Shehri az rooye dilbaran khushtar sakinanash ze shahar dilkashtar dilbaranash hame wafa angeez اندرو جز غم و علم ہمیں چیز. اٹ مسٹ بی پوائنٹڈ آؤٹ دیٹ دس از دا سیکنڈ ٹائم دیٹ دس گریٹ یونیورسٹی از ہوسٹنگ آئپٹاز کانفرنس اینڈ دا تھرڈ ٹائم دیٹ اٹ از بینگ آرگنائزڈ ان حیدرآباد. عثمانیہ یونیورسٹی ہیڈ ہوسٹڈ دا کانفرنس ان دا ایئر 2006. دس فردر پروفز دیٹ اسپیشل ٹائز ایگزسٹڈ اوور دا ایئرز between this region and Persian language and literature, and that these ties are still cherished and promoted by the people of this land of art, culture, and literature. I wish to especially thank the distinguished, soft-spoken Vice Chancellor of Maulana Azad National Urdu University, Professor Aslam Parvez, for very kindly hosting the conference at this beautiful campus, providing the delegates the opportunity to not only enjoy the wonderful hospitality offered by the university, but also of visiting the city that houses the Asafiya Library and the Salar Jung Museum, treasure troves of Persian manuscripts and exquisite artifacts. I will just read a few excerpts from this presidential address because it is already printed and you can go through that. From ancient times, Dakkan Plateau, extending over 8 Indian states, has encompassed a wide range of habitats, cultures, languages, and political dispensations. It has produced some of the major ruling dynasties in Indian history, such as the Cholas, the Pallavas, Satyavahans, Chalukya, Kadambas, the Vijayanagara and Maratha Empire, the Bahmani Sultanate, the Qutub Shahis, the Adil Shahis, the Asaf Jahis, or the Nizams of Hyderabad. It has also been a cradle of many languages belonging both to the Indo-Aryan and the Dravidian families of languages, like Marathi, Telugu, Kannada, Uriya, and a number of others. In modern India, we have divided this vast span of land into many states. This might waver our attention from perceiving its great and concentrated impact on Indian society and culture. But a patient perusal of its history reflects how Deccan has been a constant melting pot of cultures, languages, ideas, forming a unity in diversity that has been and thankfully still is the hallmark of India. Influence of Persian and its penetration in Dakani culture began even before the arrival of Alauddin Khilji and his lieutenant Malik Kafur in 13th century CE. The shifting of the capital from Delhi to Devgir or Deogarh by Muhammad Tughlaq and the frequent migration of the royal courtiers, poets, and men of letters from north to south heralded a new beginning of shared lingual and literary experiences. Later on, when Devgir became a part of the Khilji Sultanate, we have the great Khusraw extolling its wondrous beauties in flowing Persian verse. In his Dawalrani Khazir Khan and Nihatul Kamal, he extols the beautiful forts and the wonderful city of Devgir or Devgarh, which is envied even by Egypt and Baghdad, and says Khusraw, Magar khabar ze chinin shahar yaftand ke Misr fugande jame be nilo duni me shud Baghdad. It was a time when Persian was holding sway in the north. So when in 1327, Daulatabad became the seat of the ruling emperor, Persian found a natural habitat in the region. Not only did Persian language and literature flourish, and an amazing number of poets and writers contributed to its advancement and spread, it simultaneously and most effectively made inroads among the common populace and interacted with Indian languages prevalent at that time in the vast span of land then included in the area and known as Deccan. Professor Haroon Khan Sherwani writes, quote, Is bazaahir khariji zaban ne Hindustan ki zabanon par aisa zabardast asar choda jiske natije mein aaj bhi farsi alfaz taraqib aur asnaf sukhan in zabanon ka hissa hain. I'm leaving some. With the establishment of the Bahmani kingdom, Persian language and literature acquired much greater dimensions. Rulers of the dynasty believed that they descended from Bahman, the mythological figure of the greater Iranian legend and lore. Gulbarga and Bidar became great centers of Persian learning and Iranian culture. Alauddin Hasan, the founder of the Bahmani dynasty, was a great patron of scholars and learned men and an able administrator. Farishta praises Sultan Alauddin in no uncertain terms, and I quote from Tariq-e-Farishta, Sultan Alauddin Hasan, ba amri saltanat chunan chishayast wa bayast az uhdai patshahi taqasina namood روز به روز دایره مملکتش وسیع تر شد و از آب پونه تا شهر بیدر به حوزه تصرف او در آمد. به نام حسن خسروی شد تمام جهان زیر فرمان او گشت رام همان شهر گلبرگ شد تختگاه امارت برآورد بر اوج ما. I am leaving some. It must be noted with interest that most of these poets were not only writing flawless poetry in Persian, but at the same time, they were laying the foundation of proto-Urdu or Dakhani. Lutfi was a bilingual poet who composed qasidas following the style of classical Iranian masters such as Khaju Kirmani, who was very popular in the region as he was the murid of Hazrat Ruknuddin Semnani. His poetry is a wonderful amalgamation of Persian and Dakhani. So when we say even today that Persian words and vocabulary exist in Indian languages, it is not an exaggeration at all. In fact, it is a fact with which everyone in India should be familiar. Just listen to two couplets from Lutfi. On Shahid Duldul Savar, Faras Khanjar Guzar, Safdar Sharza Shikar, Sharzai Lashkar Shikan, Lutfiye Bien Par, Aine Inayat Dharo, Ae Shahe Khubani Man, Ae Mahitabani Man. Then I mention Khaja Mahmud Gawa, which I am leaving here because it will take a long time. The changeover of the rule from Delhi Sultanate to the Bahmanis was also marked by a change in the socio-cultural life of the region. Despite the continuing influence of the north, the impact of the local cultural preferences and southern overtones, the greatest contribution was creating peace and congeniality among the warring Hindu Rajas who used to rule different parts of Dakhan. Alauddin Hassan's liberal and kind behavior endeared him to the Hindu and Brahmin population, and for the first time, they accepted the royal employment. Sultan Hassan's special character and his extraordinary popularity has also been associated with the blessings of Hazrat Nizamuddin Awliya, who he had met before and who has made this prediction for Hassan. I quote, Chun Hazir Shud, Shaykh Iltifat Bisyar Farmude Ahwal Pursid, Chu Maide Bardashte Budand Nanira Ki Jihate Aftare Khod, Dar Takchae Hujre Guzashte Bud, Bar Sare Angusht Nehade Bevaidad Bagoft, In Chhatre Saltanatast, Ki Badaz Muddati Daraz, Va Mehnate Bisyar, Dar Dakan Ruzie Tokahad Shud. About Alauddin, he also said, Bezahir Darvish Babamani Padshah Ast. I am leaving some portion. After establishing the Adil Shahi kingdom in Bijapur in 1489 CE, he had made Persian the official language of his court. Yusuf Adil Shah was himself an accomplished poet of Persian and composed ghazals and rubais that show his mastery over the language and have a certain pathos and felicity of expression characteristic of Persian verse. One couplet from Yusuf Adil Shah. Ae gul raside ast bagushe to kisyam bulbul bokhond waqt sahar daastan man Yusuf bezariye diliman گوش کس نکرد کو باختان که گوش کند نکته دانه من. I'm leaving some portion. The region of Dakhan can be proud of its iconic ruler Ibrahim Adil Shah too. The greatest contribution of this artist king was towards communal harmony. He sang and composed praises of the Hindu deities like Saraswati and Ganpati. His kitab in Noras is an excellent treatise on Dakhani music. He could also easily speak Persian like a native. Farishta says, Farsi ra khub mi goft, kitab hindustani mutakallim nami shud, hech kas nami tawanast fahmid, ki ghair az farsi be zabane digar ashnai darad. Zuhri, equally famous in India and Iran for his Sakiname and his superb and elegant style of prose writing, belonged to the Adil Shahi period. He has been referred to as a savior of prose by E.G. Brown. His prose masterpiece is Sehnasr, which he wrote as a preface to Kitab-e-Nawras. He suggestively uses similes and metaphors drawn from music and two sentences which are famous. And Zaban Zade Khaswam, he says, Surud Sarayan Ishrat Kadaye Kal, Kal, Kibin Norase Sarabustanihal, Kare Kamu Zaban Sahte Vagare. Malik Kummi came from Iran and made the Khan his permanent home. This renowned poet also collaborated with Zuhuri in writing Gulzar-e-Ibrahim. I'm leaving some portion again. Qutub Shahi rulers of Golconda were great patrons of poets and scholars of both Persian and Dakhani. Kuli Qutub Shah has built a special ashkhane where poets and learned men assembled, and the Sultan himself took part in their scholarly discussions. I'm leaving some portion. His Diwan, Kuli Qutub Shah's Diwan, of course we know about his contribution to Urdu language in Dakhani language, Pia Baj, Piala, Pia Jaina. His Diwan consisted of almost all poetic asnaf, ghazal, qasida, marsiya, tarjiban. His translation in Dakhani of the famous ghazal of Hafiz is charming. Yusuf-e gumgashte baz ayat bekana gham makhor, dil tera umid ka hoga gulistan gham makhor. The last part I'm reading, leaving the rest. During all this time, the intermingling of Iranian tasawwuf with Hindu bhakti and spiritual thought gave impetus to a syncretic society in Dakhan. The mystical writings of Khaja Gesu Daraz, Shah Raju Qattal, Burhanuddin Janam, and others spread a message of peace and brotherhood. Not only khanqas, there were Hindu mat and tirth sthan all over the region. An interesting symbol of the Hindu-Muslim unity is the Urs of Ahmad Shah Wali, which, according to Professor Sherwani, is celebrated even today as per a common date of the Hijri and the Samvat. Another vivid legacy of Iran's impact on Dakhan was in the realm of visual art, importation of Persian architecture, and its intermingling with Indian style. In calligraphy, none surpassed Shah Khalilullah, who it is said had given lessons to Shah Abbas before leaving for Dakhan. Similarly, the magnificent Dakhani architecture, visible in abundance in forts, monuments, tombs, palaces, etc., is stunning in its beauty and grace. Today, the Asaf Jahi buildings such as Chow Mahalla, Purani Haveli, King Koti, Mehboob Mansion, Falak Numa, and the Hyderabad House in Delhi are reminders of the Indo-Iranian interaction. In more recent times, during the Asaf Jahi rulers' period, although it was a period of many political upheavals, yet the Nizam's great contribution to Indian culture, their untiring efforts in promoting Persian language and literature, as well as upholding the cause of Urdu and local languages, can never be forgotten. I am happy to say that even in modern times, scholars have rendered valuable services to Persian language and literature in Hyderabad and elsewhere in the region. The number is so large that it will take a separate volume to name them all. Just a few are mentioned here: Masood Ali Mehvi, Harun Khan Sherwani, Muhyiddin Qadir Zor, Abdul Qadir Sarwari, Dr. Raziuddin, Dr. Yusuf Hussain, Janki Prashad, Maharaja Sir Kishan Prashad, and others. University professors like Professor Sharifun Nisa Ansari, Dr. Yaqub Umar, Professor Bashirun Nisa, Dr. Zeb Haider, I'm sorry to say that none of them are with us today. And I'm also, but at the same time, I am happy to say that Professor Rafiq Fatima, accomplished Persian scholar, is sitting here with us today. And after quite a few years, the Anjuman-e-Ustadan-e-Farsi, the All India Persian Teachers Association, which had a tradition of felicitating distinguished professor of Persian, this year we have decided to confer this felicitation and the sanad of Ustad-e-Mumtaz ba Professor Rafiq Jahan. Rafiq Fatima, sorry. Hyderabad has also given to the world such versatile personalities as Bulbul-e-Hind, Mrs. Sarojini Naidu. This congeniality between the two neighboring countries inspired not only poets and scholars, but also artists, calligraphers, architects, painters, noblemen to migrate to India and make it their permanent home. Malikushwara Bahar writes, and I quote, Sirvate bi payan hind wa iqtizaye abu hawa ke be istirahat wa sohbat mi kashad hindi be pizi ruftane mihmanane bazlagu wa khurzaban wa hushmand aziran vadar mi sakht wa anan az hush wal zauq ishan lazzat mi burdand banabarin darbari dehli darbari buzurg tari shud ke bayad anra darbari sani iran namid balki darbari asli che رواج زبان فارسی و ادبیات در دربار دهلی در اون زمان بیشتر از دربار اصفهان بود. 500 years before قاآنی وی سی احمد لنگر دریا in India composing beautiful poetry in lilting musical meters artistically enhancing its verbal appeal like قاآنی by applying سنت تکرار دو بیت بہار آمد بے بستن ہا بہار آمد ولی بی دوست ہر ساعت بے جانم خار خار آمد بے ہر جانب نسیم و گل بے ہر سو نغمے بلبل شدے مستن ہمیں بی دل کے یادش بار بار آمد بے آمترے بزن دستی و غم را خاک برسر نہ بے آساقی بے دہبادہ کہ یار اندر کنار آید. Leaving the rest, in the end, I would like to thank so many of you, especially people sitting on the dais, Dr. Ghulam Ali Haddad Adil. The ambassador of Iran has promised to come, but then when I phoned, actually the embassy phoned me to say that he had an appointment with the oil minister. And oil minister is, of course, very, very important, it should be. So naturally, the ambassador, when he had an appointment with oil minister, he has to go, because this is a part of his duty, his diplomatic duty in India, to meet these governmental officials. So he sent his blessings, and he sent his apologies to the Anjuman. Special thanks to the Vice Chancellor, MANUU University, who has been so kind as to host this conference in such a beautiful and grand scale. And all of us are extremely thankful to you, sir. But then we know that you are so kind-hearted that when we request you, you don't have the heart to say no to us. Thank you very much, sir. Before me. اتفاقاً پس از مراسم افتتاحیه ما یک جلسه تسلیت داریم برای دو نفر ممتاز که وابسته به زبان و ادبیات فارسی بودند. یکی آقای پروفسور حافظ طاهر علی مرحوم که مال شانتی نکیتن بودند و رئیس انجمن استادان فارسی هم بودند ایشون، و دومین جناب آقای پروفسور مجتبی انصاری. برای این هر دو عزیزان جلسه تسلیت انشاءالله برگزار میکنیم. I especially wish to thank پروفسور شاهد نوخیز. اور یہ بات میں آپ سے کہنا چاہتی ہوں اپنی اور آپ کی زبان میں کہ وائس چانسلر صاحب، اس بار میں نے نوخیز صاحب کو چند مہینوں کے بعد دیکھا اور میں نے ان کو کافی لاغر پایا اور میں نے سوچ لیا کہ کانفرنس کے کام کا نتیجہ ہے. میں ان کا اور ان کے تمام ساتھیوں کا، پروفیسر عزیز بانو کا، پروفیسر رضوان کا، پروفیسر اپنے پاس میں رضوان اور بھی بہت سے ان کے ساتھی ہیں، اور تمام دانش جوئیوں کا، تمام طالب علموں کا، تمام ریسرچ اسکالرس کا شکریہ ادا کرنا چاہتی ہوں کہ انہوں نے انتھک محنت کر کے اس کانفرنس کو یہاں برگزار کیا اور بہت اچھا. آپ کے گیسٹ ہاؤسز کا تو کیا کہنا، بہت خوبصورت، بہت صاف ستھرے ماشاءاللہ آپ کے گیسٹ ہاؤسز ہیں. اور آپ نے بہت اچھا کام یہ کیا کہ ہم سب کو ایک ہی محبت میں رکھ دیا، تو ہم لوگ نہ صرف کانفرنس کو انجوائے کر رہے ہیں بلکہ ایک دوسرے کی کمپنی کو بھی انجوائے کر رہے ہیں. اور میں تہ دل سے شکریہ ادا کرنا. کہاں ہے نوخیز بھائی؟ اچھا، نوخیز صاحب کی خاص صفت یہ بھی ہے کہ وہ غائب رہتے ہیں، اس قدر منکسر مزاج ہیں، اس قدر ماڈیسٹ ہیں کہ وہ سامنے آنا پسند ہی نہیں کرتے. لیکن میں ان کی از حد شکر گزار ہوں کہ انہوں نے اتنی ان تک محنت کر کے اس کانفرنس کو یہاں پر گزار کیا. اور میں آخر میں آپ سب کی شکر گزار ہوں، سامعین گرامی، کہ آپ یہاں تشریف لائے اور آپ نے اس جلسے کو کامیاب بنایا. بہت بہت شکریہ.